find answers. But first, Godby High School back open today. Students and staff back on campus for the first time since 80% of campus flooded last week. Thank you for joining us here at 6 o'clock tonight. I'm Jacob Murphy. Julie is away from the desk. Well, LCS Superintendent Rocky Hanna said all that water caused more than $250,000 in damage. We have team coverage on the flooding recovery still ongoing in Tallahassee. Brianna Shaw will join us in a moment to talk about insurance. But first, Savannah Kelly joins us live from Godby. Savannah, how were they able to get back up and running in time for today?
Yeah, Jacob, Superintendent Rocky Hanna told me today that even he didn't think that Godby would be able to reopen this quickly. He initially estimated that it would take at least a week, but they ended up making it happen in just 4 days. Hanna said it was all hands on deck. He said that they had 2 water extraction companies, 5 cleaning companies, several landscaping companies, and street sweepers from the city, all helping to get Godby ready over these last few days. Things still aren't at 100%. Hanna says they had to move the main office to the media center and move the band room to the gym, but he says he's very proud of everyone who made this quick recovery possible to allow Godby students to stay on track.
The more time they're out of school, then we would be prolonging, pushing the school year into the summer, affecting seniors' graduation ceremonies and things that were already in place and already on the calendar. So it was extremely important that we get these kids, especially the seniors, back in school sooner rather than later.
Childs High School set up a fundraiser to collect school supplies for Godby teachers. Hanna said he appreciates this outpouring of support, but that the district is replacing these supplies internally. Hanna also said that there's going to be new drywall that needs to come in and replace some of the drywall that got damaged. She said that will likely happen this weekend. There's also new cabinets and new flooring that need to come into Godby. He estimates that that will likely happen over the summer, and he hopes that everything will be back to 100% before the start of next school year. Reporting in Tallahassee, Savannah Kelly, WCTV Eyewitness News.
All right, and you know those students and teachers were happy to be together once again after a trying few days. Savannah, thank you.